I'll walk. As in, so many of these top class fighters, they feel each other out first opening rounds. It's just a mutual respect. They don't want to get involved. And John Wayne Parr coming with some good punches. Steve covered up well there.
Yeah, mixing the shots together well there. John Wayne Parr, a former professional boxer. Australian champion, 13 professional fights, 10 wins and only 3 losses before switching to Muay Thai. And we saw a little bit of that there, putting a good combination together.
Yeah, very tidy hands. But to be fair to Wakeling, he kept his composure, kept his guard good, his eyes on his opponent. He wasn't flustered.
First time Parr has been to England. Never fought over here before, never been here before. He's thoroughly enjoyed the experience. But this would really cream it off for him now if he could take that world title home.
Both fighters looking very relaxed, just picking their shots. Good low kick there from Wakeling. Put Parr on the canvas.
Yeah, solid kick there. Seen Wakeling very tall, gangly type, and again taking their legs away. Good start.
Good defence there from Wakeling. Held the leg in, and you're allowed to throw one or two shots once you've done that. And he threw the roundhouse on his standing leg, taking it away from him. Again, Wakeling catching him.
Yeah, Wakeling using all his attributes very well here. Tall, doesn't want to stand inside though, coming back with a good right cross of his own. But we can see the pattern of the fight here. Parr going to be looking to get inside and work those combinations.
Good punches from Parr. Wakeling's not flustered at all, he's just kept his composure, tied him up. The ref came in and broke it up.
Yeah, nice solid start here from Wakeling.
Put a little short elbow inside there. Good front kick to the head from Wakeling again. Again, we're seeing some good schooling, Thai boxing. Hopefully giving us all a good understanding of what it's about. Good opening round from Wakeling.
Tremendous opening round. Wakeling using all his attributes well there. Using his height. Not getting phased when under pressure. By some good combinations from John Parr. And maybe Wakeling stealing the round, Matt.
Yeah, I feel so. Again, John Parr. You could tell the boxing experience coming in. Good combinations. Wakeling kept his composure. Just covered up and through the low roundhouse, which sent John Wayne Parr to the canvas. Good opening round for Wakeling.
Well, you'd know better than anyone, Matt. I mean, they really do kick out with some venom as well. They really are bone-crunching things when them legs connect together.
Yeah, it's all about timing. Ideal is to throw your kick and try and catch the top of the thigh or the back of the calf. But obviously, it doesn't always go. If you've got a fighter who's got a good defence, he'll raise the foot to counter it, and then you've got shin to shin. Good front kick there for Wakeling. John Wayne Parr, the slightly shorter man, is looking to. He's looking to get with those punches. I think he feels stronger with his hands.
Yeah, just looking to get inside there. I think he's finding it quite difficult to get up to Wakeling. Wakeling doing the right thing, leaning back and coming back with some good combinations.
Oh, what a beautiful elbow throw. John Wayne Parr's cut. The elbow of Wakeling's cut him. A little elbow inside. And the ref will have to have a look at that. That's why the elbow is, you know, both fighters have to agree to it. It's only the full tie rules where the elbows used. As you can see, it's very lethal.
Yeah, that seems a real back cut as well, bleeding quite heavily. I think they'll have to get the doctor up to have a look at this one. And this would be disastrous for John Wayne Parr, for it to be called off now.
No, they let it go. No, that's got to give Wakeling some encouragement. You know, his opponent's bleeding. He caught it with a nice short elbow inside.
Yeah, that really does give you energy when you see an opponent cut. And this is a perfect start for Wakeling here.
Again, Wakeling very, very tidy, throwing in those elbows, just defending well, countering.
Well, come back with a good shot there. No Parr.
Wakeling's covering up when John Wayne Parr's throwing his punches. Wakeling's covering up well, and just throwing a little short elbow inside. And with John Wayne Parr throwing punches, he's very open to the elbow. You know, very susceptible to get another cut.
Parr again, just struggling to find that range, struggling to get inside, and tried the elbow himself there. Well, this one really warming up nicely. Excellent start from Stephen Wakeling.
Although John Wayne Parr's got a far more superior record, fight record in number of fights he's had, Wakeling's definitely not looking out of his league. He's taking the fight to John Wayne Parr. Another good leg kick there.
Yeah, technically sound, Stephen Wakeling. Only 20 fights, 18 wins. Two defeats, but improving all the time, only 22 years of age.
Well, Wakeling's looking very tired, just throwing out a jab, and then as John Wayne Parr steps in, throwing the low roundhouse just to keep him at bay.
Yeah, another excellent round there, Stephen Wakeling and Parr. Struggling to work out himself, but here's where the cut happened.
The corner will have to work on that cut in John Wayne Parr's corner. I don't think it's too serious. It's not over the eye. It's not going to bleed into the way of his vision, so it should be all right. As long as they take control of it now and he doesn't get caught on it again, it should be fine.
Him working the legs there, John Wayne Parr. Trying to get that blood flowing.
Wakeling, between every round, just kneels down, touches his corner. Again, symbolic to him and maybe his camp.
John
Wayne Parr freeing the elbow there. Caught Wakeling. Good jab by Wakeling.
Seems to be another cut appeared over the eye, is it, of John Wayne Parr?
Yeah, he seems to be cut right between the eyes on the forehead. Don't know if it was another elbow, but...
Parr desperately trying to get those elbows working himself.
Oh, spinning elbow there from John Wayne Parr. Didn't quite connect. Yeah, there's a lot of blood now down the face of John Wayne Parr. How serious those cuts are, it's hard to tell, but he's definitely cut. He's trying to take the fight to Wakeling, though. Maybe he's aware of it and doesn't want to leave it.
Well, it's a good little spell here.
And that's to stop the fight.
Good little spell from Wakeling, working well with those elbows and that cut.
He's working brilliantly. He's throwing them out. It's like a second nature to him. He's obviously trained very hard for this fight.
Yeah, looks in tremendous condition.
the ref warning him about that. He held the leg a bit too long, and he didn't throw nothing off it. He just tried to push his opponent to the canvas. Oh, he's caught him on the ropes. Good combination there from Stephen Whaley.
Yeah.
Four punch combination.
Fighting excellently. Here's Stephen Wakeling. We saw his brother earlier on this evening fighting well. Good elbow there coming back from Parlo. Yeah, we saw his brother putting an excellent performance earlier on this evening, and he's doing exactly the same here, giving a masterclass.
Good body shot from Parr. He's really trying to take the fight to Whaley now, but Whaley's elbows are tremendous. He's spinning elbow from Parr. They're both on the ropes now. The ref's just breaking it up. They're not working.
The referee taking a close look at John Wayne Parr there. The blood seems to be flowing into the eyes. Maybe a problem. There's a cut in the middle of the forehead.
John Wayne Parr is a tough opponent. He is cutting. He's bleeding in two places, but he's still taking a fight to Stephen Whaley.
Singabeer, the Lion of Asia.
Cornermen have done a good job, John Wayne Parr. They've stopped the bleeding in his arm. Still pushing forward.
Yeah, trying desperately hard here.
Good punch and elbow combination there from John Wayne Parr.
Wakeling's a very good defence. Just leans back, just out of reach. Makes it very hard for Parr to get in real close with those elbows. Just the one forcing the pace here, just trying to push forward. Wakeling looking for the counter.
Again, good takedown from Wakeling. His defences are very good. He catches the foot and just throws his low roundhouse on the standing leg of John Wayne Parr and sends it to the canvas. There's nowhere else for him to go. Again, oh. Just far short there. Looking at the performances, the John Wakeling overall performance is more of a polished overall tight boxer. John Wayne Parr, his kicks aren't as clean, aren't as precise, if you want. His punches are very strong, obviously with that boxing background.
Yeah, constantly pressing forward, trying to force the pace. This shows what this title means to him. He hasn't come over to England to make up the numbers. He's really come over here to win this one. You can tell he's been training incredibly hard. And Wakeling for me at the moment, just doing a little bit too much.
Good front kicks there from Stephen. He looks in control. Beautiful jab he just threw out there. Stephen Whaley constantly on the back foot, but fighting superbly.
Leans back so well, just out of range there. Makes it so hard for Parr to get in close to land those elbows. Above the eye, just opened up again there. Towards the ground floor.
another good round. I felt he took that round definitely. The cut up above John Wayne Parr's eyes. Just open up again. His corner will have to go to work on that.
Some of the decent work in the round from Wakeling, just catching that foot and taking the legs away from Parr. He's had success from that right from the opening bell. Credit where credit's due. John Wayne Parr really forced the pace, but just falling a little bit short. The timing just not quite there, and Wakeling making it very difficult. Here we go, fifth and final round of this world middleweight Muay Thai WBC title.
Oh, John Wayne Parr's really coming. Wakeling caught with a lovely elbow. Spinning elbow from John Wayne Parr. It's just, everything's coming out of the bag now. They're just throwing shots. They both want it.
Well, I thought I was going to come down on top of us.
John Wayne Parr's out of the ring there.
Yeah, he's really going for it. Good uppercuts on the inside there. Really going for it here, Parr. He knows he needs a big round and maybe even a knockdown in it. The nose started bleeding from Wakeling now.
Good takedown again. Again, it takes so much out of you. John Wayne just looks to his corner, maybe for a rear.
Yeah, Parr's gonna go for this right until this final bell, using all his experience in there now. Wakeling, for the first time, just looking a little bit unsettled here in the fifth round.
So he's definitely on the back foot. John Wayne Parr's trying to take the fight to him. He needs to. Good body shot.
Working well again, getting the elbows in the inside there.
Both men bleeding. It's been a tough, hard fight.
Yeah, really. Gone for it here in this fifth and final round. Parr still pressing forward, looking for that big shot.
Working now in the corner, they're trying to work the knees. Wakeling just tied him up, stopped him working.
Wakeling just starting to get a little bit tired now.
Both men must be exhausted.
Well, good shot.
Judge Anne Kong Tong Kam, red 48, blue 49. Judge 2, Judge Louis. Judge 2, Louis Misha, 49 and 48. Judge 3, Craig O'Flynn, 48 and 47. It was a split decision. One judge gave to the red, one to the blue, and the other to the red, making it a red winner.
Wow.
Well, split decision there.
Yeah, I thought you can see what an upset there. Stephen Wakeling's corner looking a bit bemused by that, but
regardless,
he goes on holding the belt.
Looking a bit worried there, and credit where credit's due. John Wayne Parr put up a tremendous contest there. A tremendous five rounds of Muay Thai World Championship.
Good tough fight. We've seen some good bouts tonight.
Well, Stephen Wakeling.
He's probably stepping into the ring.